Hello and welcome to Art Tour International, the TV presentation for Art Tour International magazine. I am your host, Viviana Puello, and today we have a very exciting show for you with three international artists that are going to be sharing with us their very inspiring stories. Stay tuned. Our first guest is artist Hema Thakur from India. She met with us in Florence, where she came to receive an award at the Auditorium al Duomo. And we had a chance to chat with her about the traditional art of Rangoli. This is her story. Hi, everybody. And we are at the Auditorium al Duomo during the 80 Masters Award ceremony. We are here with awarded artist Hema Thakur from India, and we have so much to talk with her. Thank you and welcome to Florence.
Hello, namaskar. I'm Hema Thakur. माझ्यासाठी ही खूप मोठी अचीवमेंट आहे.
दिस इज द मोस्ट मेमोरेबल मोमेंट फॉर मी. दिस इज द मोस्ट गोल्डन मोमेंट फॉर मी. दिस इज समथिंग दॅट आय हॅडंट नेव्हर इवन ड्रीम्ड ऑफ. And this is something that I've achieved only because of my husband, my son, and my daughter, especially my daughter. And if these three people were not in my life, I wouldn't have reached this place ever. Because there were many people who always told me, oh, what are you doing? Why are you doing this? Why do you keep painting when you're sitting at home? Do something else. It's not going to take you anywhere. You're not even selling your paint. So why do you want to paint it? Don't waste your time. But because of these people, their support and their motivation, I reached here. I've not learned my art anywhere else. I didn't know how to paint. It was the first time I put my hands in colors, and this is what I've done. Because I always did Rangoli since my childhood, I was really interested in it. So that's how I was a bit of confident enough to go into colors and play with colors, and this is where I have reached. And I give all the credits to my family, to my husband, my son, and my daughter.
Thank you so much. And these are Hema Thakur's works. They are vibrant colors. And I think there's so much more that she brings, you know, to her work. Hema teaches a lot about yoga and meditation and as importance for inspiration, for staying inspired and letting the inspiration flow through your work. And I think she accomplishes that really well. Can she talk to us a little bit about that? How's the daily routine for her?
Actually, मी पूर्वी खूपच भित्री होती. खूप घाबरायची. मला चार लोकांमध्ये एकत्र आली की
योगा अँड मेडिटेशन इज वॉट हॅज ब्रॉट मी वेअर आय एम टुडे. आय वॉज द मोस्ट शायस्ट पर्सन एव्हर. आय यूज टू She used to even be scared to talk to the family members. But only because of the meditation and yoga that she started doing, she's become so confident today. And that is what she's showing it in her paintings, that meditation and yoga has a power to overcome all your fears. It gives you loads of confidence. And it also cures your physical problems. It makes you strong physically and mentally. So you have to include yoga and meditation in your daily routine. And that's what she's trying to show in her paintings as well. And if you do yoga and meditation in the nature, it would be more beneficial. So she's included both yoga, meditation and the nature in it. The vibrant color shows the positivity and the colors of nature in her paintings. And she's tried to show how kids are playing within the nature as well. As well of today, if you see the children, they're always busy in their gadgets, mobiles, computers. So they're always being seated, whatever. So that's the reason you can see the kids are really fat, or they're having physical problem, or they immediately go into depressions. They're not mentally as strong as what people were earlier, or how strong the parents are. The kids are not nowadays. So it's only because they are not connected to the nature, and the connection to the nature is we are stopping them from being into the nature. You're stopping them from playing. So instead of giving the mobiles and the gadgets in their hands, try and let them play push them outside. Even if they don't like, push them outside. Ask them to play. That's how they're going to be strong. And that's how they're going to explore the world. And that's how they're going to be more positive.
Beautiful message and really important. It is true. So you have rules for logging onto devices when you're at home?
No, we don't have rules for logging onto the devices when I'm home. But yeah, obviously, when it is a family time, it is a family time. Yeah. So that is for sure. Yeah. And to be honest, mom and dad have never put any kind of restrictions on us. They've always kept us free, supported us. They're more like friends than parents. And that is why we are like friends. So we support each other when we are in problem, and we encourage each other when we are happy.
That's awesome. So I do have a rule at home in the kitchen. There, we have no cell phones allowed in the kitchen. Yes. Well, I am so happy that New York City is watching this interview, because we have a big audience from India in New York. So I want to say hello to all of them. And I want to show them this beautiful rangoli that she did. And can you talk to those who don't know about rangoli? What is rangoli?
Rangoli hi ji ahe, he ek traditional ahe, ani amcha Hindu sanskruti madhe.
Rangoli is something that we make during some auspicious occasion in India, especially the Hindu people. But not only Hindu, now everyone in India makes rangoli. So it is, because the vibrant colors in it, it brings all the positivity, it attracts the positivity. And the person entering your house, after seeing the rangoli, feels so nice and positive, so the negative thoughts are left behind. And that's how the person enters your house or wherever the occasion is. So that's the reason mommy wanted to do this rangoli for you. And she loves doing rangoli. Since she was in her grade 2, she started doing this. And her father inspired her a lot to do this. So she would like to dedicate this rangoli to him, who is no more here with us. But she always misses him when she does this. And she says, I can work on rangoli for hours and hours and days, and she doesn't feel hungry or thirsty when she does this. Rangoli also has one story behind it. You might have heard about Ramayana. So Hanumanji went to Sri Lanka to search for Sita. So he wanted to get down somewhere. So Vibhishan, who was Ravan's brother, had a rangoli near the holy tulsi plant. Yeah. So that's where he got down. He went to Vibhishan's house, and then he entered the Lanka. So rangoli is really positive, and it is auspicious to draw every day as well, because it always brings positivity towards you.
And then once, after a while, what do you do? Is it destroyed?
You just wipe it off, because when you create a new one every day, that's how you create. Okay. The negative point about rangoli is you can't save it. Yeah, you have to wipe it.
कसं असतं की आपल्याला माहिती आहे की रांगोळी ही पुसली जाणार आहे पण तरी सुद्धा आपण बेस्ट
जस्ट लाईक रंगोली यू नो दॅट इट्स गोन टू बी वाईप्ड ऑफ बट स्टील यू ट्राय टू मेक युअर बेस्ट स्टील यू ट्राय टू डू युअर बेस्ट डिझाईन पुट युअर बेस्ट कलर्स इन इट इन द सिमिलर वे यू हॅव टू लिव्ह युअर लाईफ यू गेट युअर लाईफ जस्ट वन्स यू जस्ट हॅव वन लाईफ टाईम सो यू हॅव टू डू युअर बेस्ट लिव्ह युअर बेस्ट अँड दॅट इज हाऊ यू हॅव टू वर्क ऑन युअर लाईफ बिकॉज वन्स इट इज गॉन सो लिव्ह युअर बेस्ट.
I think it teaches detachment, right? Because, well, you can't be attached to it.
If you be attached to it, it's just for a short time. Every attachment has a time limit, and then you get detached. So anything that comes with attachment, it has a detachment as well. So we need to understand that. And this is what rangoli teaches us. Though it is really pretty, very beautiful, still it is going to get destroyed. So that is how you get detached to it.
You can let her know that I'm having a hard time detaching from it.
You know you're going to get detached to it. Still, you put your best efforts in it. Still, you try to make it look really beautiful. You try to make it look prettiest you can. So, you have to do it. Yeah, you know you're going to get detached to it. But still, you have to work your best. So, this is how your life is. Work your best towards it.
Well, I thank you so much for coming all the way to Florence. I thank you for participating in the Archery International TV show. We are so happy and honored to present to our audience in New York, you know, what she did here, her artworks. And I hope to see you again and again. And we hope to see you in the city, in the studios next time.
Thank you. Thank you,
Mike. Viviana. तुला पण खूप खूप थँक्यू. तू खूप गोड आहेस, खूप छान आहे. आम्हाला तुझ्यासोबत खूप मजा आली, खूपच छान वाटलं. खूप 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 थँक्यू आणि खूप प्रेम.
यू अँड आय वुड लाईक टू ॲड, टुडे माय मॉम इज अन इंटरनॅशनल आर्टिस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ यू. शी हॅज अन इंटरनॅशनल रेकग्नायझेशन बिकॉज ऑफ यू. शी हॅड मेनी मेनी नेगेटिव्ह मेसेज सेंडर्स फॉर हर. आय डोंट इवन नो हाऊ टू पुट इट. But all, whatever she's achieved yesterday is washed off everything. Oh, washed off all the negativity in
her. अगदी जागतिक दर्जाची आर्टिस्ट म्हणून मी मला आज म्हणजे रजिस्टर झालेली आहे मी आज, की नाही मला आज कुठेतरी एक खूप मोठा दर्जा मिळाला आहे. खूप थँक्यू, खूप थँक्यू.
बिकॉज देर वर पीपल हू यूज टू से oh she can't do anything, oh why are you wasting your time Mr. Thakur, why are you wasting your time on her, she's not going to do anything. So no, so it's on everyone's nose that she has done it, she has done it, and she will keep on doing it. Thank you very much, and I'm so proud for her, and this all is because of you and my father.
I tell you that this is because of her more than anything. Yeah. And her work is amazing. She has developed her own technique, she has developed her own technique out of every, she has put every knowledge that she had, her instincts, her colors, the colors of her culture, to develop a technique that is international. And if you have seen when we post her works there, the audience loves it. So she's the one who deserves the credit. The Archery International Spring Issue has an article by Emma where she's talking about yoga and meditation as the importance for creativity. So we are giving that voice at the Create for Peace column, and I thank you for your contribution. Thank you for watching, and we will see you next time. Don't forget, stay inspired. Coming up next is one of the most exciting live demonstrations that I have seen, and it's presented to you by an artist from Belgium, Frans Frengen. A very, very recognized artist in the international art scene, especially in Europe, and somebody that has developed a very unique technique that is as intriguing as the artworks that he presents. Frans started painting as a young boy, and then started painting and drawing under very recognized teachers before developing the signature technique that is the fumagine. Fumagine means painting with the light of a candle. So the artist is not using brushes, nor he is using colors or oils or acrylics. He is using the candle. But I'm not going to get into much detail because I want to share with you this video where we capture Frans during his creative process. Thank you.
The fumaging technique forms the basis for much of Franz Frengen's work. Despite the bold, thick lines, smudgy appearance, and simple nature of Frengen's drawings and paintings, they are still highly detailed and reveal the artist's deep level of skill and technique. Most of his art features people and scenes from everyday life. He chooses to highlight with spots of colors each composition. The bright colors of acrylic paint contrast effectively with the calm and serene fumaging.
Canadian sculptor Elizabeth Brownrigg, Liz Brownrigg, came from Canada all the way to Florence also to receive an award at the Auditorium al Duomo. In this Art to Heart interview, she explains to us her journey through inspiration and her journey through self-discovery and the realization of her dreams and the fulfillment of her career as a sculptor. Let's hear what she has to say. Hi, everybody, and we are here at the Auditorium al Duomo in Florence, Italy. during the celebrations of the 80 Masters Awards, and I am so happy today to present you one of our award-winning artists, Elizabeth Brownrigg, and she's a sculptor. We're going to hear about her message and her works. Liz, welcome, and thank you so much for participating in this great event.
Thank you for having me. Hello, everybody. First off, I want to say what a blessing this is to be on this platform, and to have this available for artists that, like myself, have struggled to find a platform that would allow me to express exactly what it is that I was feeling from the depths of my soul. I have been working in clay for about 7 years now. The piece that has really brought a lot of recognition is called Deeply Rooted. And the reason for this piece was actually my journey. The piece has, it looks like a driftwood piece at the base, because I have drifted in many places over the years, 32 plus, searching for, I didn't know at the time what it was for, but it was something within me that I was searching for. And when I picked up clay, I found it. I found my true calling.
It's great that you found clay, and I think clay found you.
Yes.
The pieces are really inspiring. Can you talk to us about the other one, Masquerade Beauty, because that's also, it's very striking.
Masquerade Beauty was because my past, and I feel that it, within me there's still a very big mystery of what I have to uncover. And that's where that came from. It has the peacock and the feathers because I now feel like I have the wings to fly. So there's still a lot of mystery behind myself and my journey, but I am going to unlock that mystery.
Well, tell us a little bit about your routine when you're creating, your creative process.
Well, I have a 9-to-5 day job, and sometimes my creative process is at 2 o'clock in the morning or 3 o'clock in the morning. I can't get up and start sculpting at that time because I usually have to get up and go to work, but I do keep a journal beside me. So I do my sketches, and I write everything out of what it is that I want to do. And then by the evenings after work or on the weekends, that's when it comes to fruition.
Any future plans? What's coming up next?
Being here in Italy and being here with you and in the presence of so many artists, this has inspired me to create a new chapter in my life yet again. I'm letting go of the corporate world. I'm walking away from it. And I'm going to pursue my art full time. One way or another, my dream, which is going to become my reality sooner rather than later, is to have a place where I can bring artists together and have each other not only teach, but to learn and inspire from all different mediums, because I believe that every medium has such a huge impact and a purpose for each and every one of us, whether it be culinary art, or painting, sketching, poetry, woodworking, obviously clay. There's so many different mediums that I want to bring together and have us just, again, grow, love, and enjoy, and just be in the moment.
Thank you. Thanks for being here, for being available and present during the ceremony as well, because I know it takes a lot of effort for the artists to just, you know, leave everything behind, come here for a few days and devote themselves to this, putting up the exhibition. There's so much that goes on behind the scenes of these events that the artist's energy and effort and finances, everything It's created by the artist. So I personally thank you in the name of Archery International Magazine, and congratulations on your award.
Thank you very much. And I look forward to many, many years, not only as being part of Art Tour International, but also I feel like I have met my kindred spirit. So thank you for that, and thank you for being a part of my life.
Thank you, Liz, and we'll be, I'm pretty sure this is going to be for many years as well. Yeah, I can't wait to see what's going to happen next.
Me too.
Okay, thanks everyone. Thanks for watching, and don't forget, stay inspired. I hope you enjoyed this episode of Art Tour International. We really do it from the heart. This show is presented to you thanks to the contribution of so many artists who share their talent and want to share their story and messages with you. So stay tuned for another episode next week, and don't forget, stay inspired.